Well, hello there, beloved Ascension Pioneers. Welcome, really welcome to another light activation of mine. Today is 11/11. It is the heart gateway for all of us, you know, not just the ones who are aware. Each and every being is opening the heart on their own level of awareness. And I would like to say a few words before I start the activation. And also, if you are guided so, we're just before the radio show with the Enlightened with Truth with my beloved sister Sonia Pascal. She invited me and many other healers, teachers, guides to offer our meditations, activations on this day. Of course, we're going to have just a short few minutes and the activation is going to be very shorter, you know, much shorter there in the show because we're time limited. You know, there is no time. And whenever I do an activation, it takes like, you know, as much as spirit needs. So today, on the 11/11, exactly at 11 a.m. and 11 minutes, me and my beloved, after my run, our run, we did a beautiful activation in the forest and in nature, basically really fused as one with Gaia. And I was leading with my words, guidance of the spirit, and what came through. I shared this on my Facebook page today. I was doing a writing about this and what the 11/11 is for this year. There is many who write something very similar. It is a very important, very enhanced energy. And it's here for all of us. And we can receive it as much as we're ready and open to it. As it is the same with every single thing. And that's why I like to stress that there can be no control in wanting to activate or download something through the mind because we cannot force this. As spirit beings, we are part of the, you know, cohesive forces of love, which we are all in essence, we are divine love. And everything for us is happening naturally. So we are actually made by the same perfection as source. And there's always what applies here is as above, so below. So whatever our physical bodies are going through, whatever they represent, it's the same as it is in spirit truth. So it was explained to me that, you know, everything is based on the heart. The heart is the fusion of the seed and the womb, you know, as you have with the fetus. The heart, you know, starts developing. So when the masculine and the feminine merge as the light and, you know, and the light of the source, which is the masculine, and then the feminine, when they merge as one, you know, as two polarized opposites coming together as one and unified consciousness field of all that is. What is created is the heart, and the heart is the essence of all creation, which is the cohesive force of divine love, which we all are. We are created the same way as everything else in creation. So the heart is what connects everything. And it's the same with our physical vessel. So when we have our physical heart, you have the veins flowing from the heart and back to the heart, and blood runs through these veins. And all the processes need to function properly. And for that to be so, you know, blood needs to run through the heart. So basically the heart is the pump, you know, for the whole life. And it's the same way with our spiritual heart. Everything goes through the heart when we are totally harmonized with the divine principles of creation, with our divine self. So as above, so below, like I said, and when we really totally, fully connect with our true self, with our true source self, our physicality starts matching that. And what is important here is, because we've went through many things, many phases in our human lives, we have closed a lot of these ventricles, you know, in our heart. Many compartments have been closed. And now what is happening with these energies, they're opening up many different parts. And you can imagine what happens when a certain part is closed. The energy that tries to move through it just cannot, so it bypasses it. A lot of the times the energies that are there in vain. So you can see that with the people who are not heart open, and you will say to them that you feel immense expansive energies, and they will say they don't feel anything. It's because with them the heart is closed, it will bypass their heart. And what is happening as these ventricles are opening now is the heart is opening. And when all of the ventricles are open, our heart is completely open to love as source love. So this is unconditionally, without any purpose other than just being, than just to be flow in harmony with all of creation. So when this happens, we are completely one with our organic, universal, cosmic self, with our divine self. So these energies that have been actually building up the entire year, which I always, you know, like to say and mention that 2012 was the year of healing, of wholing, of coming into our whole and complete state, and through embodiment. We cannot embody it if our ventricles are not open, because embodiment always comes through the heart, because the heart is, you know, the essence of creation. So if we are part of this creation, how we change and shift, we need to embody this through the heart. Everything is being fused through the heart, like I said. The heart, our physical heart, and many multidimensional aspects of it, and our spirit heart with the trifolded flame right in the middle, in the source, in the core of all that is, in our organic, most organic divine self. When they match, we are living beings, you know, our divine beings living in this human vessel. So all these energies that have been amplifying in this one portal, which is, like I said, the 1111 is the gateway of the heart. It started last year at 1111. We have opened this immense gateway. And it's like this year, it's like when you put a stamp onto it, it's like it's finishing up. And it's basically one of the most powerful energetic alignments, vortices right now, and of course it's followed by many other November alignments. But this is how we keep downloading. This is when we are still downloading that, and then we're going to be asked to anchor this fully grounded until the end of the year, and of course the alignment on the solstice, the 21st of December. So like I said, when all of the ventricles are completely open, that is when we can love fully with a fully open heart, and that is how Source loves. It is our complete organic state when everything comes naturally. You know, many people like to say that, you know, wow, we feel energies. It's we are entering the shift. We are moving along with the energies, because they might feel, a lot of them still, that these shifts are happening externally, and then when they happen externally, they also happen for us. But this cannot be so, because it can only be so when we vibrationally embody the same frequency. So a portal is not something that opens up and it's the same way for everyone, because the portal, our own portal, which is our I am that I am, our personalized aspect of Source, that when it opens up, it means that we, through our inner vortex, which is the heart, we enter the vortex that the Mother Gaia is experiencing as well, and at the same time all of the universe, which is expanding into another state of beingness. So we can only enter this if we vibrationally match it, if we vibrationally go through the same energetic downloads, if we open our ventricles, if we purify what is left there that is not yet completely illuminated by the light of the truth and divine love, everything that is still causing some blockages that gives us the feeling that there are obstacles. And basically what we need to do is allow ourselves to just be. This is the most powerful thing, because the state of beingness is the state of the heart-centeredness, the heart awareness. So like I said, you can imagine the heart space as being the anchor when the divine feminine and masculine meet and they create the divine child, which is basically the creation, which we are all a part of. So all the ventricles need to be open. And this is what's happening in this portal for all those who have been purifying for so long, who have been investing time to peel off the layers of everything that is inorganic, of everything that has been preventing us to be fully self-realized and as Source beings, as divine beings. So how my activation came through today was with this beautiful metaphor of the heart. Imagining ourselves with these veins, and all the ventricles being open, and us being that beautiful co-creation of the heart space. Also, the metaphor of the tree, the core is the heart, the branches of our multidimensional self, all of it. We can gather all the aspects and we bring them forth in the core. And the roots represent our grounding state, so what we're grounding in Mother Earth. But the core is always the same. The core is the heart. The firmness, you know, that which connects the branches and the roots, the spirit and the matter. So the 1111 gateway Again, like I said, it's not about desiring to activate our Merkaba or anything else like people like to say, because all these aspects of us, you know, for instance, Merkaba is our light body or light vehicle. And this can only activate naturally when we're ready for it, when we do have that multidimensional awareness, because everything needs to match itself vibrationally, like I said. But our space that is truly fully our source space is our personal vortex. And we do enter all these alignments through our own personal vortex, which is the vortex of our I am, our complete source self. So to begin with the activation, and I needed to make this speech before, prior to it, because the activation will be basically very short, shorter than usual. Because what you need to do here, if you are one of those who is watching this, is just tune into this awareness that you are entering this new through your own portal, and that your portal functions, like I said, like the heart. And imagine that this is so in spirit and in matter, because we are always created by the direct likeness, image, and perfection of the divine source of all. So I'd like to invite you to beautiful 11:11, just when I started the activation, 11 minutes and 11 seconds. So I'd like to invite you to, again, like, close your eyes, start breathing deeply, and start focusing more on your breath, not the images, not the external, to draw your focus inwardly, to gather all your awareness and bring it inwardly, right here and now. Now imagine visiting your beautiful inner tunnel, which is your heart space. And what I ask you to do now is put gently your hands, your palms, on the area where your heart is. The reason why I'm wearing the strawberry t-shirt today is because the strawberry is right where my heart is, my universal cosmic heart, where your heart resides as well. So when you place your hands there, what you are doing is you are energetically connecting to this space, your heart-centered space, which is your core, through which your personal vortex really activates, operates through. So imagine like you're entering this chamber, a beautiful chamber of delight. You know, the color that you might see is different for each and every one of us. We have traveled through many rays, different rays of creation, different multitudes, uniqueness, individuality of our beautiful source aspect and essence, our original divine spark. So whatever you might feel or see is your beautiful uniqueness. Now just take a few breaths in and out to feel your heart. Feel the tingles, feel the sensation, feel the buzzing, feel the warmth of your divine spark. One more time, breathe in the full light of your being. And know that your personal vortex space is acting through that heart space, which is your core. Now imagine the pumping veins that run towards and out of your heart, creating a loop, a cycle, in and out, the same as your breath, in and out. And you see that all of the functions in your body cannot operate without this heart center. If there are any ventricles that are closed, your body cannot fully operate. And when your ventricles are closed, when certain functions are not operating within the maximum highest of her ability, that means that you are not fully aligned and harmonized with your essence, with your source essence, because your physical heart and its state will always mirror your divine heart, your spirit heart, where your trifolded flame is, your original divine spark, as you were created by the likeness and image of Source and the perfection of all. So now we will do that which will strengthen our personal vortex. And we cannot do this without strengthening our physical heart or our spirit heart first. And how we do that is we open the ventricles that are still closed, that are still not fully operational. And you still see this and feel this, you feel your heart. But now you look within this chamber, if there are any unalignments, anything that is still closed, unpurified, not fully transmuted, fully illuminated by the light of the truth, which causes you to fully feel, radiate, and be the divine love embodied. So what we will do, we will ask these veins that keep pumping blood through our physical heart and our spiritual heart, which are the light filaments running through our spiritual heart. We ask those filaments of transmission to fully illuminate with the light of the source all of these chambers, all of these ventricles, so they can completely open up. So we can love through utmost purity of source, through utmost divinity, so we can love as source loves, totally, willingly, devotedly, and unconditionally. We see these ventricles lighting up like a light is being lit there in every chamber, wherever there might have been some darkness. There is light. It illuminates, it opens up all the ventricles. We ask for this light of the source, of the truth, to fully illuminate all of the ventricles, all the cells. And so that this is then transmitted through the spiritual essence of our heart to the physical aspects of our heart, which always reflects our spiritual heart. As above, so below. As we feel these chambers lighting up, opening up, as the ventricles keep opening and opening and opening, we feel an immense burst of divine love flowing through. And we see that nothing in this awareness, in this space, and during this activation of the 1111 portal, the gateway of the heart, nothing, literally nothing, can bypass the heart anymore. For all the gates are open. All the ventricles work perfectly, in alignment with the greatest attunement and in perfect harmonization with our spiritual self, by the likeness and image of source, of all. Through our hands, we can now feel the strong sensations, pulsations, buzzing, tingling sensations. And we know that this means that we are being opened, activated. And how we feel is, we feel in complete unison with all that is, in complete trust of all that is unfolding, in complete awareness of ourselves as divine, as beings of divine love. We now fully understand that bypassing the heart means that the energy is not fully flowing through our center. But now with this openness, the energy of source can flow freely, and we can start embodying our beautiful I Am presence. So as this heart core is activated, strong, emphasized, and it has an immense endurance, strength, and capability to be firm in its essence, we also see now that our personal vortex can really start doing its purpose, can start amplifying. And we feel this now, our personal vortex pulsating, and we feel this as a beautiful golden thread moving through us in a spiral movement up and down and extending in all directions, in all directions, up, down, left, right, outwardly, inwardly, the pulsating spirals of our personal vortex, which are of the golden thread, are pulsating immensely. And we might even feel that we start moving from right to left, counterclockwise. That means that our source self, our personal vortex, is being activated, running directly through our heart gateway, our heart portal. So now we ask our personal vortex to keep strengthening every day, every now moment, that it is always in alignment with our heart essence, spiritually and physically, that our spiritual and physical always match, are always in divine resonance and reflection. And now we start seeing ourselves as a beautiful tree, the divine tree of life. We are this tree of life, and our heart space, our heart vortex, is where the core, the root of the tree is, the trunk of the tree. We see our branches extending upwards and in all directions, and this is our multidimensional self. And we feel that we can activate and tap into all of the branches, all of the layers of our multidimensional self. We can connect and tune into any part of us in every now moment, always. Because once this personal vortex is activated, we're always within it. As above, so below. So we see these branches in a beautiful golden light, and we look down below and see the roots going firmly, grounding firmly in our core of the earth to our mother earth. Still, there is a golden thread running through the branches and the roots, and right in the middle, there is our heart gateway, the direct link with our personal vortex and with our I Am, which is the direct link with the great I Am, the I Am that I am of all. We're still spinning counterclockwisely. And we ask our personal vortex to amplify. We start spinning more, faster, stronger, and we feel that the vortex is strengthening. It's strengthening. And through that, we finally feel that the way of the gateway is from within to without, that we can only enter any sorts of dimensional awareness and consciousness through our own inner vortex, which we have now just activated. So, whenever we wish to, whenever we desire, we can imagine ourselves as this tree. We are the tree of life, and we connect matter, we connect spirit. The heart is the direct connection of the masculine and the feminine, of the seed and the womb. It is the part where all creation is one. It is the part of unity consciousness. And when our personal vortex is strengthening, so is our heart, and vice versa. We can do this at any time. Simply by being aware of it, we're already activating it, bringing it into matter, embodying ourselves as divine love. We breathe one more time into our vortex, and whenever we breathe into it, we are already enhancing it. We're expanding. We're pulsating. We're being. And being is the non-describable, the non-definable. It is the Tao. It is the force of all. It is the creatrix, the matrix of all living things. It cannot be named, cannot be labeled, but it just is and feeds all life and all creation. And through that personal vortex, we always have a direct link to it. We thank ourselves. We thank our soul. We thank our heart. We thank the energies, the divine anchoring here in the planet and through our own gateway of the heart. We thank our personal vortex. We thank every aspect of creation, and we thank the living matrix of all that is. And we feel how beautiful it is to just be. And this is what the new is all about. When you're ready, you can open your eyes. So how does that feel? Well, your heart, your strawberry, whatever you wish to call it, it is the direct gateway to your personal vortex. And I hope you nurture it. I hope you continue to open it. And I hope we can all, and I know, not just hope, that we all love how Source loves. So I'm gonna share the link of the show with the shorter live activation down below. And I'm looking forward to many new things that the 1111 energies and many other energies, which are basically all one and the same energy of the divine, finally rebursting here on the planet and reawakening the human and the divine potential in all the humanity and other aspects of creation, not just the human, and feeling ourselves as the whole part of whole of everything. So let's continue to love as Source loves, and let's continue to love one another, to co-create with one another, and I'll see you soon and on another light activation. Have a beautiful weekend, and have a beautiful beginning of the new week, and as energies intensify in November, I'm going to be happy to hear from you and your experiences of these energies as we continue in the last 2 months of 2012. I love y'all. Bye.